हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर जितेंद्र राय, फैकल्टी ऑफ एमसी डिपार्टमेंट फ्रॉम टेक्निकल इंस्टीट्यूट एडवांस स्टडीज। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट लेक्चर ऑन एमबीसी आर्किटेक्चर। बिफोर डेवलपिंग द वेब एप्लीकेशन वी नीड टू हैव आइडिया अबाउट डिजाइन मॉडल। देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ प्रोग्रामिंग मॉडल्स। नंबर वन इज मॉडल आर्किटेक्चर, मॉडल टू एमबीसी आर्किटेक्चर। मॉडल वन आर्किटेक्चर बेस्ड ऑन सर्वलेट एंड जेएसपी टेक्नोलॉजी। बेसिकली सर्वलेट एंड जेएसपी आर द मेन टेक्नोलॉजी टू डेवलप द वेब एप्लीकेशन। नंबर वन, सर्वलेट वॉज कंसिडर्ड सुपीरियर टू सीजीआई। Sublet technology doesn't create process, rather it creates thread to handle request. The advantage of creating thread over process is that it doesn't allocate separate memory area. Thus, many subsequent requests can be easily handled by sublet. Problem in sublet technology: sublet need to recompile of any design code is modified. It doesn't provide separation of concern. Presentation and logic are mixed up. Number two is JSP. JSP overcome almost all the problems of sublet. It provides better separation of concern. Now, presentation and business logic can be easily separated by JSP. You don't need to redeploy the application if JSP page is modified. JSP page provides support to develop web application using Java bin, custom tags and JSTL, so that we can put the business logic separate from our JSP. That will be easier to test and debug. You can see that in my diagram, JSP first client send the request to JSP. After that, JSP again request to JavaBin. JavaBin again request sent to database. Then database accept the all requests from web browser. Then report back to response to JavaBin. JavaBin that JSP. JSP request to sublet browser. Then client access the all accept requests from JSP and database. And they can access any browser. They can access any application in that browser. As you can see in the above figure, there is pictures which show the flow of the model world architecture. Browser send request for the JSP page. Then second, JSP access JavaBin and invokes business logic. JavaBin connect to the database and get save and data. Response is sent to the browser, which is generated by the JSP. This diagram will be based on the model one architecture. This is very beneficial to other user. That user will be working on online applications. Advantage of model one architecture: easy and quick to develop web application. Disadvantage of model one architecture. Number one, navigation control is decentralized. Since every page contains the logic to determine the next page, if JSP page name is changed, that is referred by other pages, we need to change it in all the pages. That lead to maintenance problem. Number second disadvantage is time consuming. You need to spend more time to develop custom tags in JSP so that we don't need to use script tag. Number third advantage is hard to extend. It is better for small application but not for large application. If we can develop large application, they can extend more time and more time consume. So we can choose another architecture based on MVC architecture. Number two architecture, MVC architecture. Model two based on the MVC model view controller design patterns. I am explaining the MVC architecture. MVC stands for model view controller. MVC design pattern consists of three modules, models, view, controller, model. Model, the model represents the state, data, and business logic of the application, view. The view is the responsible to display data. It represents the presentation. If we can view any client's review, if we can review any browser's review, then we can show in the view part. Controller, the controller modules act as an interface between the view and model. It intercepts all the requests, receives input and command to model view to change accordingly. If we can use controller that receive the input from users and user receive the input from other part and controller send again request to the view controller, then both are working in collaboration of that models. In that diagram, the user send the request to controller again send the request to view. The view access the page of JSP page and the view again request to model. Model access the page of JavaBin. Then JavaBin send the request to database and database again accept the request and send back to response to model and controller. And controller again back to request to web browser. Then web browser client access the web page and access to any conditions and access to any online interface application. There are various advantages of model to MVC architecture. Number one advantage, navigation control is centralized. Now only controller contain the logic to determine the next page. Second advantage is easy to maintain. If we can maintain online application, then we can use easy to maintain using MVC architecture. If we can maintain any application online, so if we can use easy to extend, easy to test, we can test easily in the web online. online application, better separation of concern. There are various advantages followed by MVC to architectures. Number second, disadvantage of model to architecture. If we need to write the controller code self, if we change the controller code, we need to recompile the class and redeploy the application. So we can explain the various types of MVC, model number one and model number two. Both models are working on the online environment. If any client working on that part, they can use on MVC architecture. Without MVC architecture, we cannot access any web application. So all servlet and JSP technology, Java Bean technology, and other technology based on working on MVC architecture. Because MVC is navigation control providing, easy to maintain, easy to extend, easy to test, and better separation of concern. So I hope you understand my topic, MVC based on architecture. There are two models, MVC 1, MVC 2. So thank you very much.